His story must have started when he was in the First World War. Many times I've heard that was the bloodiest war of all. He must have made his mind up then if he saw it to the end. He'd have to make some changes, then he'd come home again. And when the war was over, he could never settle down. He'd work sometimes for farmers and he'd move from town to town. He never really made a plan, he just lived from day to day. He didn't seem to notice as the years just slipped away. Old man of the mountain, what happened in the war? Was something lost forever there that you were searching for? Was it fear of killing or the fear of being killed that made you want to live out there alone upon the hills? When the Second War began in 1939, went into the mountains and he left the world behind. They only saw him in the town when his army pension came. Then he'd stock up his provisions and be on his way again. And in the Comora Mountains he lived for 20 years, like a hermit in the wilderness, in his ragged clothes and beard. Some say that he was crazy or that he was just afraid. Some saw quiet dignity in his solitary ways. Old man of the mountain, what happened in the war? Something lost forever there you were searching for. Was it fear of killing or the fear of being killed that made you want to live out there alone upon the hills? I can still remember the day I heard he died. I was only 8 or 9, but it touched me deep inside. Though I never knew him, I still felt I'd lost a friend. There was something gone forever that I wouldn't find again. Old man of the mountain, what happened in the war? Was something lost forever there you were searching for? Was it fear of killing or the fear of being killed that made you want to live out there alone upon the